The Amazon rainforest is the largest tropical rainforest on Earth. Occupying an area roughly equal in size to Australia, it contains an estimated 390 billion trees. It is also the most diverse ecosystem on the planet, and astonishingly, a single hectare may contain more species than all of North America. The question of what produces this diversity has intrigued biologists for hundreds of years. Geographic barriers, such as mountains or oceans, are important for the evolution of biodiversity because they divide populations of animals, allowing them to evolve into new forms and species. But in the endless Amazonian forests, there are few obvious geographic barriers, yet nonetheless, there is a huge diversity of life. So the question is, what produces all of this diversity? So the aim of the project was to study polymorphism in butterflies in the Amazon basin. Making maps of butterflies using museum specimens suggests that there's a region of very high diversity along the course of the Amazon River. The problem with this pattern is that it's not clear if it's a real biological phenomenon or if it's a pattern that's been produced by unequal sampling efforts, because in historic times, the only places that were accessible to humans in the Amazon were those that are along the major rivers. So when people went collecting butterflies in the 1800s, they tended to only collect along the Solimões, along the Amazon, and the other major Amazonian rivers.
A Amazônia, particularmente, tem uma riqueza muito alta. Isso nota-se em vários grupos, né, de bicho, planta. Muita gente tentou entender desde muito cedo, na história da ciência, por que que tem tanta diversidade lá. Uma das hipóteses, uma das ideias que a gente tem de como que se explica essa grande diversidade é a presença dos rios.
The museum data suggested that the Amazon River is a region of very high polymorphism. The way we wanted to test it was by sampling along a transect and taking equal numbers of samples close to the river and away from the river to see if polymorphism really does decline as you move into the forests. As with humans and blue and brown eyes, butterfly species can also have variability in their wing color patterns. To the north of the river, you have one color pattern. To the south of the river, you have another color pattern. And then along the Amazon itself, you have individuals which are exhibiting both of these two color patterns.
Borboletas, elas são um ótimo modelo de estudo por diversas razões. Eu nunca encontrei um modelo que é tão versátil, sabe? Mas o principal para a gente aqui, como modelo para responder essa pergunta, é que elas são diversas, elas existem ao longo do transecto inteiro, elas são bioindicadoras e fáceis de coletar, né?
Starting in Manaus, there is a road called BR-174 running almost perfectly perpendicular to the Amazon, which is a nice opportunity just to start collecting close to the river and then moving away from it. And the transect is also interesting because it crosses a number of habitats. It starts in lowland rainforest, it passes through drier, sandy forest habitats and wetter, swampy forest habitats, and then it finishes in a savanna ecosystem on the frontier between Brazil, Venezuela and Guyana.
Então a gente resolveu fazer dois métodos também. Então um é buscativo, fazer com a rede entomológica, né? Então você vai no campo procurando o seu grupo de interesse, no nosso caso eram todas as borboletas, e coleta. O outro método foi o de armadilhas. É um método mais padronizado, então vai ser sempre aquele número de armadilhas naquela altura da floresta, espaçadas com tantos metros de distância. E fizemos esses dois métodos em todas as localidades. Então seguimos o mesmo padrão em todas, mesmo número de dias, etc, etc. Vamos ficar dois meses aí na estrada, né? Que são 4 dias em cada, mais um dia de transporte, vezes 10 localidades, 50 dias. E todos os acidentes que podem acontecer, dá 2 meses só de coleta.
Lindo, né? Então, chegando na trilha, a gente vai colocar as iscas em todas as armadilhas, uma mistura de banana com açúcar mascavo e água. Ela ficou fermentando por 48 horas e agora a gente vai colocar em todas as armadilhas da trilha.
Tá cheio de mariposa nessa armadilha. Essa aqui é amorfo, azul. Esse azul não é cor de pigmento, né? É uma cor estrutural. Então são propriedades da célula muito, muito pequena. É como a célula se arranja mesmo, que faz com que, dependendo da luz que bate, ela brilha com uma cor diferente.
When you think about territoriality, you don't usually think about butterflies, you think about mammals as having territories, but in fact, heliconias have territories too. They sleep in exactly the same place every night. They sleep in a group, a social group. In the daytime, they go out and they forage in the surrounding forest. They have quite developed brains, apparently, for butterflies, presumably because this is quite sophisticated behavior for an insect.
Quanto mais eu fui conhecendo até a ponto de chegar na Venezuela, a savana realmente é fantástica de linda, assim, a imensidão mesmo que some de vista, né?
A gente coloca ela aqui e ela tem que ficar quase fechadinha no envelope.
Para cada animal há um ponto de força, né, que é somente para colocar no envelope.
So first, I'm just going through everything that we collected today and identifying it and writing the details on the envelope, the date, the place that we got it, the species, the sex of the individual.
So all this work is for these precious samples, this material, and doing this every night after we come back from the field is difficult, but if we don't do this, we lose track of important information, and then the samples may even become lost, like useless.
We collected about 3,000 butterflies in that trip, and the majority of those butterflies will go into the museum of the University of Campinas. The museums, they are really wonderful sources of information on biodiversity. You can think of a museum as a biodiversity library where each species is a book and each specimen is a page in the book for that species. By collecting along a transect running across the middle of the Amazon basin, our research has shown that the diversity of butterflies is highest close to the major rivers. So it seems that the biogeographic patterns shown by the museum specimens were real, and that the enormous rivers divide populations of butterflies, allowing them to evolve in different directions on either side. Sadly, the biodiversity of the Amazon is under threat. The emerald forests are being gradually eroded by a seemingly inexorable tide of deforestation. By studying the butterflies of the Amazon, we hope not only to show how biodiversity evolves, but also to share the beauty of this forest with others, in the hope that by doing so, we may contribute to its long-term preservation.